Hey everyone, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. There, we're in the air. Took a little bit, but that doesn't surprise me. This is my space plane that's going to leave. It's completely overkill, but I think it looks nice. That's also why it took off rather slowly. I actually based it around one orange fuel tank, which is, well, quite a lot of fuel. I can take the space plane to the moon. But yeah, why would you do that? It's a plane. But yeah, anyway. Just slowly climbing here. Probably gonna time warp in this bit. But not quite steep. But well, it can do that. So why not do it and save some fuel? Besides, trim and the new SES don't really go along. Especially if I use a joystick. Like, if I change it a little bit, or at least try to nosedive first and then pull right up again, which is kind of annoying, but whatever. Let's just keep going the way we're going. This is the interesting bit, I guess. I can slowly hear my engine's RPM go up and up. And, oh, okay, yeah, there's the SES. Never mind that. Yeah, let's get up some more speed. Let's fire those rockets. Now those jets are speeding up. The way I said about it is that I can disable the outer engines first, in pairs, then the middle ones, and then the center one can just flame out. It doesn't really matter because it's in the middle. I just don't want the outer ones to flame out. That'd be pretty bad. It'd just make me spin. Yeah. I love the engine glow in the darkness. I notice the middle one glows a bit more. Oh, yeah, right, that's because of the orange fuel tank. It overheats a bit more. And there it goes. That should be alright. Right, as you can see before, I launched the space plane way too early. So it's now in a lower orbit than the, what did I call it? IPS? Yep, that's what I want to call it now. It's right behind it, and it's in a lower orbit. So, yeah, it's gonna take a while for it to catch up. Oh well, might as well use the time now, eh? Yes, I'm launching this refueler now, might as well do it now. The top part there has about... it has the exact capacity that two orange fuel tanks will have. If I need any more fuel than that, which I probably will, I'm just gonna send up another one. I didn't really want to overcomplicate this one. Oh. I think we're alright. yeah. Yeah, I didn't want to complicate this one, I just want to get the fuel up and do more interesting things than building refuelers, honestly. It's a bit wobbly, even for those struts. I guess that makes sense, there's a lot of weight on top. Well, I think I can... oh no, don't break please. I think I'm even going to have to do a gravity turn. It kind of seems to do it on its own. Well, not quite. I am nudging it a little bit. It's just hopping around a lot. It looks like a string of bows on the side now. That's not good. Stage soon though. So I think he might be alright. It's gonna be enough. Looks really spindly. Nope. Yeah, that sound again, I hate that. Looks pretty stable now though. Okay, maybe not quite, but... ooh. That might help. Again, I hope those fuel tanks are treated with some kind of special paint, you know, to protect them from rocket exhaust. Yes, I know that does make a lot of sense. Just ignore me. Seems to be going quite fine though. I wonder how much fuel we're gonna have left on. Well, at least what I messed up the first time worked out pretty good this time. Just after two orbits this happened, then didn't even have to do anything. Well, that was a pretty smooth docking, I think. This one's gonna be a bit more fun. Trying to squeeze in this plane between four fuel tanks with less than half a meter clearance on all sides. Right, I think I might be coming in a little hot here. Yeah, this isn't going... Okay, hold on. Get away from it. Was it enough? Yeah. Phew. Damn. Killer reflexes, alright. Just kidding. Alright, well, guess I'm gonna have to do this again. Right, much better. If only I could see where I'm going from this side. I guess I could. They're gonna have to retract it again, though. Don't think that's gonna fit in there between those tanks. Oh, I'm driving the wrong way around, too. That helps. Right. Please keep the heading all right, and now it's... Whoa. Okay. Shaky camera. That was weird. Whoa. What's up with that? Weird. Okay, I think a little bit more up and to the right. Pitch the nose down a little bit up, and I think then I can go in. after retracting the landing gear, of course. I still need that now, though. Yeah, I'm too low. Yeah, that looks good. I can't tell if I'm still moving. I mean, upwards. Yeah, I think I should just try and go in. I really don't want to collide with it. So I don't know what would actually happen if I did, but honestly I don't want to find out. Yeah, just a little bit up and I think I'm fine. Yeah, that looks good. Hold on, I'm gonna have to retract these soon. Don't want to smash those nukes. Probably should have docked the other way around. I hope I measured this correctly. I'd hate to have one of those wings clip something. Oh, down, 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 down. Nope, not that much. Right, looking good. Bounced a little. Ah, there we go. Yay! Wait, the lights work with them retracted? Damn, I wish I'd known that. Okay, I just refueled my Minecraft as much as I can. And now I can deorbit this refueler with RCS. That's gonna be fun. Pull button and pull my finger. Oh. Anyway, if I remember the sound for a splashdown of a multi-part rocket, I might want to cover your ears. But yeah, thanks everybody for watching, and I'll see you all later.